Hello friends, my name is Ankur Shukta, here in the Gate Coach, and I am recording a small video lecture for a brief introduction about the non-ideal reactor designing, as some of you asked for that. Okay. So first question is, what is non-ideal reactor? Okay. So we all of us know that reactor is any vessel or equipment in which reaction takes place successfully under some specific conditions. And what is non-ideal reactor? So we can classify the reactors into two categories. One is ideal reactor and one is non-ideal reactor. Okay. And ideal reactors are those, if I say in simple terms, ideal reactors are those where all molecules have same residence time. And non-ideal reactors are those where molecules have different residence time. Okay? So, what is the meaning of this term? So, see, if I draw an ideal reactor, let's say this is our block diagram of any ideal reactor, and this is a block diagram for a non-ideal reactor. Molecules are going in, leaving, going in and leaving. Okay. And what is the residence time? So, all of us know that residence time is the time spent by a molecule within the reactor. Okay. So, in case of ideal reactor, we know that molecules are going in with some bulk velocity, let's say that is U naught or U zero, and the bulk velocity of all the molecules will be approximately same. In the same way here, in non-ideal reactor, the bulk velocity of feed, let's say U naught, and that too will be same for all the molecules approximately. Okay. And this is the residence time T. So now all of us know that distance is equal to speed into time. So in the same way here, distance travelled by molecule within the reactor will be the product of the bulk velocity of molecule and multiplied by their residence time. In the same way here, the distance travelled by the molecule within the reactor will be equal to the bulk velocity of molecule and the residence time of the molecules. So now you can see that in case of ideal reactor, bulk velocity is same and residence time is also same. So the distance travelled by all molecules will be same as well. Okay. But in case of non-ideal reactor, bulk velocity of all the molecules is same, but the residence time spent by the molecule within the reactor will be different. So the product means the distance travelled by the molecule will be different as well. So what is the meaning of that thing? Agar aap ise thoda different way mein dekhte ho, that in ideal reactor, all molecules traveling the same distance. Okay? It means all molecules have same flow path. But in case of non-ideal reactor, distance traveled by all molecules is different. So it means we can say the flow path for all molecules is different in case of non-ideal reactor. And flow path is provided by the reactor, that depends on the reactor geometry. That's why we use the term non-ideal reactor. Means this non-ideality is basically the characteristic of reactor, not the reaction mixture or anything else. Okay, so I think it is clear to all of you why the residence time in non-ideal reactor is different for different molecules, because the distance traveled by molecules, the flow path of the molecules in the reactor is different, and that depends on the reactor geometry. Okay, so that is something about the non-ideality of reactor. Now we will talk about the causes of non-ideality. Why the molecules have different residence time here? So basically, there are n number of reasons and for non-ideality, but here we will talk about mainly three. One is dead zone, second one is turbulence, and third one is bypassing. Okay, so what is dead zone? As the name suggests, dead zone. समझ रहे हो? मतलब जैसे लाइफ में होता है ना कि अगर कोई पर्सन डेड हो गया तो द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ दैट पर्सन टू कम बैक इन रियल लाइफ इज ऑलमोस्ट जीरो, और वी कैन से ही मे कम बैक इन रियल लाइफ आफ्टर इनफाइनाइट टाइम. तो इन द सेम वे इन अ रिएक्टर वेयर वी हैव एक्सट्रीम कॉर्नर्स, दिस इज इनलेट, दिस इज आउटलेट, एंड वी नो दैट नॉर्मली द मिक्सचर प्रोफाइल इज पैराबोलिक बिकॉज ऑफ द एजिटेशन. So because of these extreme corners, if any molecule got trapped in these, then the probability of those molecules to leave the reactor will be almost zero. And the time spent by these molecules, when they are not leaving the reactor, then obviously the time spent by the molecule in the reactor, the residence time, will be infinite. इट इज़ जस्ट लाइक अगर हम डेली लाइफ में देखें, घर हैं, घर में हम साफ सफाई करते हैं, तो अगर कोई एक्सट्रीम कॉर्नर होता है, ठीक है, वहाँ पे आप डस्ट निकालने का ट्राई करो विद द हेल्प ऑफ झाड़ू और एनीथिंग एनी क्लोथ, तो वो नहीं आएगा, समझ रहे हो, नहीं आता बार विदाउट वैक्यूम क्लीनर. तो सेम वे यहाँ पर भी अगर कोई मॉलिक्यूल ट्रैप हो जाते हैं तो वो बाहर नहीं आएंगे, एंड दैट इज़ द रीज़न मे बी नाउ डेज द मॉडर्न एज रिएक्टर्स हैव हेमिस्फेरिकल और सिलेंड्रिकल बॉटम टू अवॉइड द एक्सट्रीम कॉर्नर्स सो दैट वी डोंट हैव द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ डेड जोन. ओके, एंड नेक्स्ट वन इज बाईपासिंग. वॉट इज बाईपासिंग? टू स्किप द प्रोसेस वेन सम अमाउंट ऑफ इनलेट इज डायरेक्टली सेंड टू द आउटलेट बाय स्किपिंग द प्रोसेस. इन द सेम वे हेयर इन दिस रिएक्टर, this is inlet, this is outlet. Okay, logically if the molecule is going in the reactor, it should get mixed and then leave. That is the path the molecule should follow. But what happened in practical life, there are some molecules which directly go to the outlet. Either they have very high velocity or very high inertia force, so they directly move to the outlet and skip this mixing zone. So we say that molecules are skipping the mixing, skipping this zone, so means they are bypassing. And in this case you can see the residence time of the molecule in this reactor is very small, means almost zero, or short residence time you can say. Next one is turbulence. What is turbulence? Basically it is related to mixing. Okay, this is inlet, this is outlet, this is agitator, and you know that there is a mixing zone. Maybe you have heard about the term vortex formation and all. Okay, so you know that vortex formation is what? That there are some molecules got trapped in the mixing zone. अगर कोई मॉलिक्यूल किसी वॉर्टेक्स में ट्रैप हो जाता है तो वो उसी में रोटेट करता रहता है कंटिन्यूअसली, सेम पाथ फॉलो करता है, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट इफ देयर इज एनी न्यू मॉलिक्यूल इट विल नॉट एंटर इन द मिक्सिंग जोन बिकॉज देयर इज नो वैकेंट स्पेस. एंड इन द सेम वे इफ एनी मॉलिक्यूल इज ट्रैप्ड इन दिस, तो इट विल टेक अ वेरी लॉन्ग टाइम, वेरी लास्ट टाइम टू लीव द रिएक्टर. ओके, दैट्स व्हाई इन केस ऑफ टर्बुलेंस द रेजिडेंस टाइम इज वेरी लार्ज, नॉट इनफाइनाइट बिकॉज इट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ प्रोसेस. तो इट डेफिनेटली ही the molecule will leave the reactor, but after a very long time. So if you draw a curve between number of molecules leaving the reactor to the residence time, then because of the bypassing some molecules have very small residence time, so they will leave early. Then some molecule will leave near the mean residence time. Then some molecules will leave because of turbulence, have very large residence time. And if there is any molecule in dead zone which has infinite residence time or very, very large residence time, so that molecule will not leave the reactor. So that's why this curve will never going to touch the x-axis. Okay, and this long tail represents the dead zone in the reactor. This is turbulence and this is bypassing. Okay, very short residence time. And we can see that in non-ideal reactor, molecules have different residence time. So when we draw the curve, it is like a distribution curve. And the analysis of this distribution curve of residence time of different molecules is known as RTD, that is residence time distribution. Okay? So this is something about the basic part. After that, I will discuss about the how to find out the residence time distribution curve in the reactors and what is the parameter or what is the element we use to identify that residence time distribution curve, that is basically tracer, and how to inject that tracer in the reactor. But that I am not going to discuss in this video, that we will discuss in the class or you can ask me personally. Okay, so now I will directly move to the new topic, that the input methods of tracer in the reactor. So first I will talk about the pulse input experiment. See guys, as of my experience in this industry from last 5-6 years, this is one of the underrated topic of CRE, because people think it is very difficult, the RTD part. But I tell you that this is the most easy topic of this subject, and you can score 100% marks from this topic, because every time in GATE exam you will get a question from this topic of 1 or 2 marks. Okay, I don't know why, and for this year there was no question on this topic, but before that, from 2000 to 2017, we were having a 1 or 2 question from this topic every time in the exam, and those are very basic and easy questions. So if you know the meaning of each and every term here, and you know the basic mathematics of class 10th and 11th, then you can solve any problem of RTD. Okay, how? That we will discuss. So pulse input experiment. One point is, what is pulse input? So we know that pulse input is basically the sudden injection, sudden disturbance in the input profile for a very small fraction of time, like this. There is nothing going on and suddenly there is a disturbance and then again back to zero. So this is, let's say at t equal to zero, this is the tracer inject profile or input profile, we can say, to the reactor. Sudden pulse is there. Okay, this is pulse input, just like we used to inject the serum or any medicine with the help of injection in any human body. Okay. So let's say if I draw a block diagram of any reactor. So this is the feed going in the reactor with the volumetric flow rate V0, and this is the mixing point where I am injecting my tracer at t equal to 0, and at the reactor outlet, this is the detection point where I am measuring the concentration of tracer with time. Okay, and this is the concentration of tracer. That is basically the exit concentration of tracer. Okay, with time. So you know that because of the non-idealities, the exit concentration will be different for different time period. Okay, and when you draw the curve will come something like this. And the curve drawn between exit concentration of tracer versus residence time for pulse input experiment is known as C curve. Okay, and at infinite time that curve will touch the x-axis, means all molecules will leave the reactor. Okay, so how to find out that curve and all that we will discuss. So for next is, and all these things we can find out by with the help of material balance or mole balance over tracer. Okay, so let's say we want to calculate the amount of tracer leaving the reactor between time t and t plus dt. Okay, and that is, let's say dn. N represents the number of molecules of tracer. So dn is the amount of tracer leaving the reactor between time t and t plus dt. Okay, now see, you know that if there is any tank and the exit flow rate is, let's say, 3 kg per minute. Okay, then how much amount of this fluid material will leave in 3 minutes? That is 3 into 3, 9 kg. And how much amount of this material will leave between 3 minutes and 4 minutes? That is 3 into 4, 12, minus 3 into 3, 9. That is 3 kg. So in the same way, the amount of tracer leaving the reactor between time t and t plus dt is the molar flow rate of the tracer at exit. That is the volumetric flow rate multiplied by exit concentration of tracer. So it is molar flow rate of tracer at exit. And this is a reactor is operating at a steady state. So that's why the outlet volumetric flow rate will be V naught as well. Okay, multiply by the time interval. Let's say equation 1. Okay, so this is the amount of tracer leaving the reactor between time t and t plus dt. And let's say if we divide this and by N naught, that will be like dN over N naught is equal to, and dn is the amount of tracer leaving the reactor between time t and t plus dt. So dn over n naught, which is the total amount of tracer we injected in reactor. So amount leaving the reactor divided by total amount will be what? Fraction of tracer leaving the reactor between time t and t plus dt. Let's say equation 2. Okay, and I believe that in statistical mathematics you have studied about the probability distribution, binomial distribution, Poisson distribution and normal distribution, etc. So in all of the curves, when we analyze the distribution curve, there was one thing common, that we want to find out the mean value, median and mode, standard deviation and variance of the curves. Okay, and all these things, all these parameters we calculate with the help of some distribution function there. So in the same way, this residence time distribution is basically the application of probability distribution. Okay, all these things are based on probability distribution, but we will not talk about that because this is not the math class, this is the CRE class. So we will discuss that thing, how to use that. Okay, so here as well, for this C curve, we will define a distribution function known as exit H function, which is like V naught into multiply by Ct divided by N naught. let's see equation 3. Okay, and what is exit age? So exit age is, can it is just analogous to the residence time, but definition wise we can say it is the time taken by the molecule to leave the reactor. Time taken by the molecule to leave the reactor. So now see, it is just like the residence time. Here residence time can be defined as the time spent by the molecule within the reactor. So when the molecule entered in the reactor, that is t equal to 0, and when it leaves the reactor at time t, that duration we call residence time. But in the same way here, in exit age, we say it is the time taken by the molecule to leave the reactor. Means we are waiting at the outlet to leave the we are waiting at the outlet of reactor for the molecule to leave. Okay, so what we are doing, as you can see in this experiment, we are injecting the tracer at time t equal to 0 and it enters in this. Okay, now we are waiting at outlet for the molecules to leave, and when the molecule will leave, we will calculate, we will measure their concentration with the help of titration, chromatography, or n number of ways are there, and we will draw the curve. Okay, and this is what we call exit age, time taken by the molecule to leave the reactor. Okay, so from equation 2 and 3, it is clear that dN over N0 is equal to ET into dT. Okay, and what is dN over N0? This is the fraction of tracer leaving the reactor between time t and t plus dt. So in the same way, this ET dT will also define as the fraction of tracer leaving the reactor between time t and t plus dt. Okay. So if you integrate this point, so at time t equal to 0, the molecules leaving the reactor will be 0, because at 0 we are injecting some molecules, so they will not leave. And the time required by the molecules, the time at which all molecules will leave, will be infinite because of the dead zone. And when you solve this, it will be like so you can write it as 0 to infinite ET dt is equal to 1. Okay, and let's say this is equation 4. ET dt was fraction of tracer leaving the reactor between time t and t plus dt, and when we integrate this from 0 to infinite, means in total time interval, the fraction of tracer will leave the reactor will be 1, and it should be 1 obviously. In total time interval, all molecules will leave the reactor, so the fraction will be 1. So this is correct. Okay, and here the 0 is the time at which molecules, where here the meaning of this 0, the initial limit is the time at which molecules have started to leave the reactor. Actually, time at which means time after which. Okay, and the infinite, it means the time at which all molecules have left the reactor. Okay, so it is not the 0 and infinite, it can be also 3 and 25. Okay, there is a reactor at t equal to 3 minutes, molecules have started to leave, and all molecules will leave till t equal to 25 minutes. So the limits will be like that. Okay, I think it is clear to all of you. Okay, then now see this equation 4, this represents one more meaning. As all of us know, the application of integration is, it also represents the area of some function. Means in this curve, it represents the area of this E versus time curve. So if we draw a curve between E versus time, so it will be like this, and this curve will leave at t equal to infinite, will touch the x-axis, okay? In the curve drawn between E, exit-age function versus time is known as E curve, okay? Now I think you will think that why the shape of this curve is like this. So if I say that remember equation 2, from equation 2, et was like v naught over n naught multiplied by ct, okay, and the c curve was like this. So you can see v naught is constant because a steady state reactor is there, n naught is the total amount of tracer molecules which is already constant. So we can see that et is directly proportional to ct. Okay, and that is the reason the nature of E curve will be same as that of for C curve. If C curve is linear, then E curve will be linear. If C curve is parabolic, E curve will be parabolic. If C curve is triangular, E curve will also be triangular. Okay, and what is the area of E curve? So you can see from this curve, this equation 4, that from limits 0 to infinite means in total time interval, the area of this curve will always be 1. Okay, so remember this, guys, this is a very key point in this study, that area of E curve will always be 1 for the total time interval. Okay, and the area of E curve represents the fraction of molecules, fraction of tracer leaving the reactor between given time interval. Okay, so if someone asks you to calculate the fraction of tracer leaving the reactor between time t1 and t2, so it would be like we have E curve something like this. So just calculate the area of curve between time t1 and t2, or you can write it as mathematically integration of t1 to t2 of et dt. Okay, now there is one more thing, that what will be the mean value of the curve, okay, or we can say the mean residence time. We have different molecules with different residence time, so what will be the mean residence time of total reactor? So we can denote it by that value, mean residence time by T bar, and we know that mathematically the average of any term will be based on integration. And here the distribution function is ET, so based on that we can define the mean residence time. Okay, but the value of this curve, this function ET dt from 0 to infinite will be 1. So T bar will come out to be 0 to infinite of T into ET dt. Okay, and now we know that in industry we are dealing with mixture, so we define normally concentration terms, we don't deal with moles for the mixtures. Okay, so the exit from equation 1, you know that we were having dN is equal to V naught CT into DT. So if you integrate this function, तो एट टाइम टी इक्वल टू जीरो मॉलिक्यूल्स लीविंग द रिएक्टर विल बी जीरो एंड टाइम रिक्वायर्ड बाय द मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑल मॉलिक्यूल्स टू लीव द रिएक्टर विल बी इनफाइनाइट. ओके तो इट विल बी लाइक एन नॉट इज इक्वल टू वी नॉट इंटीग्रेशन फ्रॉम जीरो टू इनफाइनाइट सी टी इंटू डी टी. एंड नाउ फ्रॉम इक्वेशन थ्री इफ यू नो दैट एन नॉट ओवर वी नॉट कैन बी रिटन एज सी टी ओवर ई टी is equal to 0 to infinite integration of ct dt. Okay, so the et will come out to be like ct over integration from 0 to infinite of ct dt. Write any equation 5, 6 or whatever it is. Okay, so now see et is equal to ct over this. And what is this part denominator? Integration of ct dt from 0 to infinite. And what is ct? Ct is the concentration of tracer at exit of the reactor. Means it is a result. And this is basically the area of C curve. Now tell me one thing. All of you have must have cleared your 12th and 10th examination. So can you change your 10th result? The value of 12th result? No? Obviously, because those are results and those are constants. So in the same way, in C curve, which is the curve between exit concentration of tracer versus residence time, which is a result. So this area will be constant. So ultimately ET is proportional to CT because this is constant, because that is the area of C curve. And C curve is the result, outcome of the process. So the values will not change after coming out. Okay. So now when you put that value in this equation, you will get T bar is equal to integration of from 0 to infinite of T into CT dt divided by integration from 0 to infinite of CT into dt. So this is one way to find out the mean residence time. Okay, so this is something about pulse input experiment and all. There are so many points to discuss that we will discuss in class. Okay, or you have any doubt, then you can ask that in your comment section. Now I am just wrapping all this by solving a numerical from the GATE examination, which came in the GATE exam from on 2005 or 2006. Okay, so there was a question in GATE exam that we have given a E curve, the units of exit age function is minute inverse versus time, that is in minutes. Okay, the curve is something like this. This is 3, 8, 15, 0 and this value was E max. So aapse pucha tha first, what is the value of E max? And second, what is the value of mean residence time? So this question was there for 4 marks, 2 plus 2. So it is a very simple question. For a pulse input experiment, RTD curve was given. This E curve is basically known as RTD curve of the reactor. Okay, remember this. So now you have to calculate Emax, but we don't know how to calculate that, but we can see it is a triangle and we know that area of a triangle can be written calculated by half into base into height. Okay, and because from the definition of E curve we just calculated that the area of E curve in the total interval will be 1 always. So here in the total interval from 3 to 15 the area of E curve will be 1. So the value of E max will be 1/6. Very simple. दिस क्वेश्चन वॉज देयर फॉर टू मार्क्स. नाउ यू कैन इमेजिन विच काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन केम इन एग्जाम. ओके, वेरी बेसिक कॉन्सेप्चुअल क्वेश्चन. नेक्स्ट इज टी बार, मीन रेजिडेंस टाइम. सो वी नो दैट टी बार कैन बी कैलकुलेटेड बाय द इक्वेशन लाइक दिस. ओके, सो फॉर दिस कर्व द इक्वेशन विल बिकम द टाइम आफ्टर विच मॉलिक्यूल्स स्टार्टेड टू लीव द रिएक्टर इज 3, द टाइम टिल विच मॉलिक्यूल लेफ्ट द रिएक्टर 15, टी इंटू ईटी डीटी. ओके, बट नाउ वी कैन सी इन दिस फंक्शन, इन दिस कर्व देयर आर टू स्लोप्स, कर्व इज चेंजिंग. ओके, स्लोप्स आर चेंजिंग बिटवीन द टाइम इंटरवल्स. सो दिस टी बार कैन बी रिटन एज इंटीग्रेशन फ्रॉम 3 to 8 ऑफ टी इंटू इवन टी डी टी प्लस इंटीग्रेशन फ्रॉम 8 to 15 ऑफ टी इंटू ई टू टी डी टी. लेट्स से दिस पार्ट इज इवन एंड दिस पार्ट इज ई टू टी. ओके, पुट द वैल्यूज ऑफ इवन एंड ई टू एज अ फंक्शन ऑफ टाइम इन दिस इक्वेशन एंड यू विल गेट योर आंसर. ओके, नाउ हाउ टू फाइंड आउट, सी दिस इज वॉट अ स्ट्रेट लाइन इक्वेशन एंड वी नो स्ट्रेट लाइन कर्व एंड वी नो दैट द इक्वेशन यूज टू रिप्रेजेंट द कर्व स्ट्रेट लाइन कर्व कनेक्टिंग बिटवीन टू पॉइंट्स विल बी लाइक y माइनस y1 इज इक्वल टू y2 माइनस y1 ओवर x2 माइनस x1 मल्टीप्लाई बाय x माइनस x1. ओके, सो फॉर दिस केस इट विल बी लाइक ऑन y एक्सिस वी हैव e even t माइनस y1 दैट इज 0, y2 माइनस y1 दैट इज 1 बाय 6 माइनस 0, x2 माइनस x1 दैट इज 8 माइनस 3, ऑन x एक्सिस वी हैव t तो इट विल बी t माइनस x1 दैट इज 3. सो हियर यू विल गेट even t इज इक्वल टू 1 ओवर 30 t माइनस 3 and which is valid for time between 3 to 8. Okay, and for time between 8 to 5, the function of e2 will come out like minus 1 by 42 t minus 15, which will be valid only for this time interval. And when you put all those value of e1 and e2 in this equation, you will get T bar is equal to approximately 8.67 minutes. Okay, and this question was there for 4 marks. Very basic question. You just need to put the values in the equation, and if you know the equation, you can solve it. But the meaning of the terms should be clear, that the area of E curve will always be 1 between total time interval, the T bar, E max, and all those things. Okay. So this is all about the pulse input experiment which I want to discuss. There are some more part in RTT chapter that we cannot discuss obviously here in this video. It will become otherwise 2 or 3 7 hours lecture. So that we will discuss in our class. So if you have any further doubt or you need any further clarification, then you can mail us or comment us in the section. Okay, thank you guys.